Bryan Forbes, you're not supposed to start interviews this way, but I do think the film is a treat, and I've gone on record as saying it, so that's got that out of the way. Do you not find it extraordinary that this has never been done as a musical before, other than the cartoon version?
Well, I believe they did do a sort of spectacular in America, didn't they? Rodgers and Hammerstein did it about 6 years ago. I remember getting the record. It was a TV special, but it's never been done for what is known as theatrical film, no.
Actually, it's very old in the cinema. There was a version made in 1898 by G.A. Young, but not a musical.
No, and also I found out when I was researching the script, there is a version in the Chinese which goes back to 846, I believe.
Did you find any fundamental difference between directing a musical and a non-musical?
Well, it's longer and it's more fun. I mean, the schedule was much longer. It was about 24 weeks we were shooting, as opposed to, I suppose, 12 weeks on an ordinary film. But mostly, I mean, going down to the studio at 8:30 in the morning and plunging into some ghastly emotional scene is not my idea of fun. But I think doing a musical, you have music on the set all the time, and it's a much jollier atmosphere.
I watched you very closely on the set at Pinewood, and what amazed me was your calm. I mean, you're running into overtime, it's costing millions, and there's a hare in the gate, and yet you're looking incredibly good. What's the secret? I mean, how do you do this?
Well, you've got to avoid the ulcers, I suppose. There's nothing really you can do about it. Nobody tries to sort of delay anything. I mean, things do go wrong. And if you panic, well, then you communicate your panic to the artists, and they are the poor people who finally are up there on celluloid, and nobody cares whether the director had a temperament or not. I mean, they are stuck there, and it's very lonely out there in front of the cameras.
You break a personal rule, I think, in this film. In your autobiography, you say you don't believe in screen tests because they just register varying degrees of panic.
You're very perceptive.
But you tested Gemma Craven.
Yes, because she had never filmed before, and it really wasn't an acting test, which is what I abhor. It was a singing test. And we had to convince a lot of other people. I mean, I was convinced, but we had to convince a lot of other people. And it wasn't entirely my own film, as you know. So I had to show evidence on the screen that Stuart Lyons and my judgment was there. And I think it was there because I took the unusual step of having made a screen test, of showing it to the press intact.
You also say in the book that if there were an Olympic goal for pessimism, you'd probably win it. Not in those words, but I mean, you're hopeful about this.
Well, I'm always pessimistic, really, because I've learned that that's the only way you don't get too disappointed. I mean, one never sets out to make a bad film, but sometimes the critics think that you have made a bad film, and so I'm never wise before the event. Sometimes I'm not even wise after the event.
It's your third picture with Dame Edith Evans. I wonder if we could pull her over.
I'll grab that young lady. Dame Edith. This gentleman would love
Dame Edith,
to interview.
Do come and join us.
What do you want to say to me?
Well, I'd like to ask you how this happy working relationship with Bryan Forbes began, because you've now done, I think, three pictures together, haven't
you?
Three, haven't we?
We are probably
Mad Woman of Shio and
Well, we've done four, actually, because, of course, I did a documentary about Dame Edith.
Yes, of course.
So that counts as four.
Well, I suppose he thinks I'm a good actor. So he likes to have me acting with him, and I like working with him. That's the excuse enough, isn't it?
It's a lovely part. You've got all the good laughs.
I don't know. I've never seen it, you see. I haven't seen it at all. I'm longing to see it.
I think you'll enjoy it.
I never went to any rushes.
No, you really are going to be tried out tonight, aren't you?
Yes, very much so.
Do you by and large go to the cinema for pleasure, Dame Edith?
No, I don't go very often at all. I live in the country. The last 3 or 4 years. Otherwise, I lived in Albany for over 30 years, and I went to everything then. But you can't, I live 47 miles away, you see. It's quite a little jaunt.
Yes, it is. Well, enjoy it tonight. Thank you very much, Dame Edith Bryan Forbes.
Thank you very much.